Hey everybody, I'm playing the impromptu game that I didn't get to finish, or the series that I didn't get to finish, and that's between the Hall of Famers and the not-so-Hall of Famers. The series was tied 1-1, and I never played a follow-up game. I got involved in the League of Desperation tournament and totally forgot about this, so thought I'd take the opportunity while I'm on lunch break at work to try to get the game in as much as I can, and then maybe finish it up after work if I don't get the whole game in. So I will eschew the lineups, just get them as we get to them on the at-bats to try to save time. Although I will say that Bob Feller is going to start for the Hall of Famers and Kevin Brown is going to be the starter for the not-so-Hall of Famers. So we'll get going right away to expedite things, and Dee Gordon will lead things off for the not-so-Hall of Famers. And the roll is a 6-4. And on Bob Feller against a lefty, a 6-4. If I can get this focused correctly. There we go. 6-4 is a strikeout. So Bob Feller doing what he does best, striking people out. Gets the first out, and here's Rafael Palmeiro. And that's a 6-9. So a 6-9, again, off of Feller against a lefty, is a walk. So we go from one extreme to the other, a strikeout to a walk. And that brings up A-Rod. And we get a 1-11. This time A-Rod against a lefty. 1-11 is a ground ball, third base A. That is a 5-4-3 double play to end the inning. And Bob Feller takes care of the not-so Hall of Famers in short order. Like a short order cook. Three batters and three outs. So face the minimum, and now that'll bring up Joe Morgan, little Joe, to lead off against Kevin Brown to start the bottom of the first. We get a 1-4. Joe Morgan, a 1-4, just missed a homer. 1-5 would have been a homer. 1-4 is a fly to right. So there's one away. And here is Ted Williams, Teddy Ballgame. Teddy Ballgame, a 5-5, so we're off Kevin Brown. That is a strikeout. So Kevin Brown says to Bob Feller, I'll match a strikeout for a strikeout. Two away, and here's Jolting Joe, who hasn't been jolting too much lately. He's been on a slump. 2-8. 2-8 for Jolting Joe, and he's still slumping. Ground ball to third. Handled by McGuire over there. And that's going to be 1-2-3 for the Hall of Famers. So after one inning, we got nothing. And that'll bring up Mr. Big Neck and Big Head himself, Barry Bonds. He was the fathead before fatheads became fashionable to put on your wall. He was the original fathead thanks to the juice. So here is Bonds. It's a 3-9. 3-9 against Feller. 3-9 is a walk. 3-9 is a walk. So Barry Bonds walked a lot. He does it here. And that'll bring up Sammy Sosa. Sammy Sosa, a 6-8. Feller, a 6-8, is yet another walk. So back-to-back walks. That's three walks by Feller already. And on the season, his 41 season, he did walk 194. So it's not unusual for him to have a little issues with the strike zone. Here's Canseco, Mr. Steroid himself, Mr. Juiced himself. 110. 110 is a 1-15 will be a homer because we're not doing ballparks. So 1-15 would be a homer. Anything else will be a fly out to left field. And that's a 9, so that is a 3-run shot. 3-run shot for Canseco. And the not-so Hall of Famers have grabbed a 3-0 lead off of Feller. Here's Mark McGuire. Right now, Feller's pitching like old Feller. Or old Yeller, one or the other. 6-7. 6-7 for Feller is going to be a split chance. 1-8 will be a single. Anything else will be a line out to third to Schmidt. It's a 6, so that's going to be a single. So the hits keep coming. And that'll bring up center fielder Juan Gonzalez, who's a little bit out of place. We don't really have a center fielder on this team, so he'll have to fit the bill. 1-8. 1-8 is going to be another single to right field. McGuire doesn't run all that well, so he will stop at second. Runners at first and second, still nobody out. Bullpen's active now for the Hall of Famers. Here's Ivan Rodriguez. Pudge, a 4-10. Pudge, a 4-10. Ground ball shortstop X, that's Cal Ripken. He's a 1. Oops, let's re-roll this so we can see it. 1 and a 12 is probably an error check. Almost positive it's an error check. And it is. So Ripken is an E12, so we'll roll for his error rating. And we get a 4. 4 on a shortstop E12, a 4. E12 to 4 is a 1 base error on Ripken, so when it rains, it pours. As Ripken boots it, a rare boot, and that will load the bases, and there's still nobody out. Back to the top of the order in D. Gordon. And we get a 4-8, so 4-8 against a lefty is a strikeout. So Bob Feller with the strikeout. 4 out number 1. He's gotten Gordon twice on strikes. It's Palmeiro. Palmeiro of 5-10. 5-10 is a ground ball third base X. This one is Schmidt. He is also a 1. And that's a 3, so that's going to be a good play. That was a 3. I just hit it. Let's see here. It's not a 9. It's a 3. And a 3 on a third baseman with a 1 is a ground ball A, and that's going to end the inning. 5-4-3 double play will do it. As Palmeiro grounds into the double play to end the inning. But 3 runs do come across. I guess technically it could have been worse. But it's a 3-0 lead for the Not-So-Hall of Famers. Now, granted, the Hall of Famers certainly are capable of putting up some runs, so certainly not panic time yet for them. Here's Say Hey Kid, Willie Mays. Mr. Say Hey, it's a 3-2. 3-2, he just missed a homer. 3-2 is going to be a fly to left. So one away, and here is Hank Aaron. Hank Aaron steps to the plate. And we get a 1-6. 1-6 for Hank Aaron. It's going to be a single. So base hit, first hit of the game for the Hall of Famers. And that brings up the Mickey Mantle. Switch hitter batting left. It's a 6-5. 6-5 is a strikeout, so Kevin Brown got him. Out number 2. And now we're down to Mike Schmidt, but he's certainly capable of putting one over the fence. And that's a 1-11. And a 1-11 is going to be a single to right field. So another single. Hank Aaron will stop at second. Down by 3. They're not going to take any chances on the base pass. Johnny Bench, the catcher, is coming up. And that's a 4-6. 4-6. That's going to be a strikeout. So Kevin Brown gets out of it. Kevin Brown with the got the K going in this game. And after 2 complete, it is 3-0 in favor of the Not-So Hall of Famers. And now A-Rod will lead things off. A-Rod, a 1-3. 1-3 is a ground ball to short. And 1 away. That'll bring up Barry Bonds. And since I'm recording this at work, I don't have my usual setup, so I am playing this one-handed again, which I don't mind. 2-9 is how I started. 2-9, Barry Bonds, 2-9 is a strikeout. And there are 2 away very quickly for Sammy Sosa. Sammy Sosa, 3-9. Not only does Sosa do steroids, but he also corked his bat, so he was kind of double I can't think of the right word for it. He walks in this at bat, but he was double guilty, you know, double perpetrator, I guess you could call it. All right, here's Canseco. He had the big 3-run homer his first time up. This is a 5-10, so we're off of Feller's card. And 5-10 is a ground ball third base X. That is going to be Mr. Schmidt. And Mr. Schmidt, an 8. An 8 is going to be an error check. So Schmidt is an E21. E21, and that's an 11. So an E21 and an 11 is a ground ball A. So that will work for Schmidt. He makes the play, and the inning is over. So nothing doing for the Not-So Hall of Famers. We go to the bottom of the third. And the only batter not to step to the plate in the game yet, the starters, is Cal Ripken. He is batting in the 9th position. He will lead off against Kevin Brown. He's one of the few that actually faced Kevin Brown. So it's a 6-6. 6-6 for Kevin Brown. That's a ground ball to short. So Brown has just gone through the order once and pretty much rolled. Gave a couple of singles, and that's it. Here's Morgan. It's a 3-9. Maybe the second time around will be different. 3-9 is going to be a walk. Walk to Morgan. And you would normally think about running, but Pudge Rodriguez is a minus 5 arm, so not going to take the chance, not when you're down. Here's Ted Williams. Williams a 5-9. 5-9 is a ground ball shortstop X, and that's A-Rod, who's a 2. And that's a 14. So a 14 on a 2 rated is ground ball C, which means Morgan will advance as Williams is out. 4-3 for out number 2. Morgan is in scoring position for Jolton Joe, and he will pretty much score on any base hit, unless it's a 1-star. 4-9. 4-9. Well, he's going to definitely score because 4-9 is a 1-3 for a triple. 4-20 is a double. So Jolton Joe finally put a jolt into one. It's a 7, and that's a double. So Jolton Joe has just hit an RBI double to score Joe Morgan. One Joe scoring the other. And it's a 3-1 game all of a sudden. Tying run steps to the plate, and Willie Mays. It's a 6-10. 6-10 for Willie Mays. That's a fly to center field. No ballpark effect. So the inning's over, but the Hall of Famers do strike for one. And at the end of three, it is the Not-So-Hall of Famers 3 and the Hall of Famers 1. And that will bring up Mark McGuire. He will lead off the top of the fourth. McGuire singled his first time up. This is a 2-6. 2-6 for McGuire is a split chance. 1-6 will be a single. 1-6 will be a single. And he got a 3, so it is a single. So McGuire has done it again. 2-2. And that brings up Juan Gonzalez. Gonzalez, a 1-10. And that's a home run. Juan Gonzalez has just gone yard. 1-10 home run. And I think that's going to do it for Feller. He just didn't have it. He pitched like an old feller in this one. So he is out of there. And we'll be right back with a new pitcher. All right, so Raleigh Fingers is taking over in relief here in the top of the fourth. It's 5-1 Not-So-Hall of Famers. First batter he faces is Rodriguez. Ivan Rodriguez. It's 5-3. 5-3 is a ground ball pitcher X, and Fingers is a 4-rated pitcher, and he's an E-12. So the roll for the range is going to send us to an error check, and Fingers is an E-12. So Fingers, an E-12. Let's see what he can do off of an E-12. It's a 5. E-12, 5, that's another error. That's an error on Fingers. So the first batter he faces, and he boots it. E-1. So the Not-So-Hall of Famers, the Hall of Famers, a little sloppy in the field now. Two errors already. Here's Gordon, struck out twice. And we got a 3-9. 3-9, he's going to strike out again. So that's the hat trick for D. Gordon. He is the only one of the Not-So-Hall of Famers not doing anything in this game, pretty much. Here is Palmeiro, and that's a 2-5. 2-5 is a ground ball second base C. So that will advance the runner. Ivan Rodriguez will go to second with two outs. And that brings up the other Rodriguez, Alex Rodriguez. And that is a 2-8. 2-8 is a single to center. We're not using the clutch effect, so the single's going to stand. Single to center. Now, Mays is a minus 5 arm. He was being held on, was Pudge. So he's a 13, it'll be a 12. You add 2 for 2 outs, makes it a 14. But then you got a minus 5, makes it a 9. So they're going to hold him. They're not going to run on Willie Mays. So Pudge will stop at third. Runners at the corners, 2 outs for Barry Bonds. And that's a 1-9. 1-9 to fly to left. Missed all those homers in column 1 and found a fly to left to end the inning, but two runs come in for the Not-So-Hall of Famers, and we go to the bottom of fourth. They got a 5-1 lead, and the Hall of Famers have their work cut out for them against the surprisingly effective Kevin Brown. So Kevin Brown. Oops, as the dice goes off the deep end, much like the Hall of Famers are going off the deep end. So we got a 211. 211 for Hank Aaron, and that's going to be a fly to left. He missed a lot of hits in column two and found a fly to left. One down. Brings up the Mick. Mickey Mantle, a 6-7. 6-7 against the lefty is a walk. So Kevin Brown with his second walk of the ball game. We'll bring up Mike Schmidt. Schmidt, a 4-6. 4-6 for Schmidt is another strikeout for Kevin Brown. He is racking them up and is pitching like a Hall of Famer. Here's Johnny Bench. 1-4 for Bench. 1-4 is a fly to center, and that's going to do it for the Hall of Famers. They go quietly in the fourth. We go to the fifth. It's still 5-1, not so Hall of Famers. And Sammy Sosa steps in against Raleigh Fingers, who will be in his second inning of work. Raleigh Fingers. It's a 6-2. 6-2 is a strikeout. So Fingers got the strikeout on Sosa for out number one. Brings up Jose Canseco. It's a 1-5. 1-5 for Canseco is a home run. He found it right there. Big bold bold letters. 1-5 is a homer. Canseco with his second home run of the game makes it a 6-1 ball game. Here is McGuire. It's a 6-6. 6-6 against Fingers is a strikeout. So Fingers comes back to get the strikeout on McGuire. Here's Juan Gonzalez. And we got a 5-8. So 5-8 off of Fingers against a righty is a ground ball second base X. That's Little Joe, Joe Morgan. And he is a 1. And it's an 8, so it's probably an error check. We'll verify. It is an error check. So on Morgan, he's an E13. And we got an 8. An 8 on an E13. An 8 is a good play, ground ball A. So Morgan makes the play to retire Gonzalez and end the inning, but the not-so Hall of Famers tack on another run thanks to a Jose Canseco solo shot. We go to the bottom of the fifth. It's now 6-1, and now the Hall of Famers might start to panic because innings are running out. Here's Cal Ripken. It's a 5-9. 5-9 against Kevin Brown's a ground ball to short, and that's going to be A-Rod, who's a 2. And that rolls an 11, so that's an error check. And A-Rod, on his error check, is a E-19. And you rolled a 3. An E-19 and a 3 is a one-base error. So, finally, a blunder for the not-so-Hall of Famers as A-Rod boots it. And that'll bring up Joe Morgan. Morgan, a 6-5 against Brown. 6-5 is a strikeout. So, Kevin Brown, yet another strikeout. That'll bring up Teddy Ballgame, Ted Williams. And that's a 1-9. 1-9 for Ted Williams. And he hit into a double play. How do you like that? 1-9 is a ground ball shortstop A. That is a 6-4-3 double play. And that's going to do it for the Hall of Famers in the fifth. They are done. We go to the sixth with the score 6-1 in favor of the not-so-Hall of Famers. Raleigh Fingers is going to go one more inning, and he'll be facing Yvonne Rodriguez. Yvonne Rodriguez, a 3-4. 3-4 for Rodriguez as a ground ball pitcher A, so easy ground out there for one away. Back to the top of the order, here's Gordon. He struck out all three times. It's a 1-7. Not this time. He's going to get a single this time. 1-7 is a single. He will take it. And as a show of respect, up 6-1, they're not going to steal. So Rafael Palmeiro, the batter. It's a 1-7. 1-7 is a split chance. 1-8 for a double. 9-20 is a fly to center. It's a 15. That's a fly to center for out number two. And now it's A-Rod's turn. And A-Rod, a 4-6 off of Fingers. is a single to center field, so base hit, and Gordon will stop at second. So two down, two on, two down for Barry Bonds. Barry Bonds against Fingers, 5-9, is a strikeout, so Fingers came back to get him. And that will end the inning in the sixth, so Hall of Famers are done in the sixth with nothing doing, but they do still lead it 6-1, and they're averaging a run an inning, which is kind of alarming against the Hall of Famers pitching. Here's Joe DiMaggio, Jolton Joe. He had an RBI double his first time up. It's a 1-6, or his last time up, I should say, 1-6. 1-6 is another double. This one's a leadoff double, but double nonetheless. And here's Willie Mays as the Hall of Famers look to make a rally here. 2-8. 2-8 is a pop out to short, so that's not going to help. There's one away, and here's Hammer and Hank Aaron. See if he can hammer. So far, he has been nailed, not hammered. All right, 6-10. 6-10 is a fly to center, and he is now 1-for-3 on the day. Two outs for the Mickey Mantle. It's a 2-10. 2-10 for Mickey, and Mickey Mantle hits a two-run homer. So big bold letters right there, home run, 2-10. So Mickey Mantle homers to cut into that lead a little bit. It is now a 6-3 ball game. So there's at least a little bit of hope and life in the Hall of Famers. Here's Schmidt. Schmidt, a 5-8. 5-8 for Schmidt, 1-15 will be a single. 16-20 is a ground out. It's a 12, that's a base hit. So the inning's still going for Johnny Bench. Mr. Krylon Paint, Johnny Bench. It's a 4-4. 4-4 off of Brown is a fly ball center field X. And Juan Gonzalez is in playing in center, even though he's kind of out of position. He's a 3-rated fielder. That's a 12, so it's probably an error check. We'll verify that, and it is an error check. And Gonzalez is an E5. So it's an E5 as a center fielder, and that's a 4, and that's a two-base error. A 4 is a two-base error on Juan Gonzalez. So error number 2 by the Not So Hall of Famers, Schmidt will have to stop at third base, though, because you only get two bases on that. And that'll bring up Cal Ripken. Ripken's 0-for-2. He did reach on an error last time up. 6-8. 6-8. Oh, he's got a chance for a base hit. 1-15 will be a base hit. It's only one star, but they'll take it. It's a 12. That is a base hit. So Ripken singles, and that will score Schmidt. It's now a 6-4 ball game. Bench only goes one base, so he stops at third. Tying runs are on base now for Joe Morgan, and now the Not-So Hall of Famers bullpen is active. Joe Morgan, a 4-7. So 4-7 is a strikeout. So Kevin Brown had not reached his point of weakness yet, so the strikeout is good. And the inning is over, but the Not-So Hall of Famers lead has shrunk. It is now, after 6 complete, the Not-So Hall of Famers 6 and the Hall of Famers 4. Okay, we're back for the top of the seventh, and as you can see, the new pitcher for the Hall of Famers is Nolan Ryan. Yes, he is mainly a starting pitcher, but he does have a rating for relief. In 1973, he did actually have a save, so despite his 39 starts, he did have a save, so that's good enough for me. So he's going to come in with the score 6-4 and try to hold the Not-So Hall of Famers in check. And what I decided to do to maybe help the dice rolls not scatter so much here at the office is I'm going to use the runner advancement chart here as a place to roll dice. So maybe that will work out better. We shall see. We're going to try it right here. First time, Sammy Sosa will be facing Nolan Ryan. So we'll see how this goes as we start inning 7 with the score, Not So Hall of Famers 6 and the Hall of Famers 4. Here's Sosa against Ryan, and we get a 1-9. 1-9 is a strikeout, so definitely not something unexpected from Nolan Ryan, although it did come off of Sosa's card. Sosa was also a big strikeout guy. Here's Canseco. He's homered twice. That's a 2-10. 2-10, he's going to ground to short. handled easily by Cal Ripken. Two down for Mark McGuire. McGuire, a 3-6. 3-6, and he will walk. So a two-out walk to McGuire. And that will set things up for Juan Gonzalez. May have been a teammate of Ryan's in the early 90s, I'm not sure. Don't know if they ever crossed paths on the Rangers at the same time. 3-3. 3-3 is a ground ball to short, and the inning is over. So Nolan Ryan breezes through the top of the seventh. We go to the bottom of the seventh, and the Hall of Famers will be coming up to try to cut into that lead even more. And there's a new pitcher, as Kevin Brown has been lifted, and Henry Mejia, the erstwhile former closer of the Mets in 2014, which is where this card is from, Mejia did have 28 saves. So Mejia is in, and he will be facing Joe Morgan, the top of the order. I'm sorry, Morgan made the last out of the sixth. I forgot to move his card. So actually, Teddy Ballgame. So he gets to start the festivities facing Teddy Ballgame. Teddy Ballgame's 0-3 with a strikeout and grounded into a double play as well. It's a 6-11 off of Mejia. That's a fly ball to right. So handled out there by Sosa for out number one. And Teddy Ballgame is still hitless. Here's Jolton Joe DiMaggio. He's doubled twice. So he does against Mejia. It's a 2-3. 2-3 is in a ground to short. So Mejia dispatching of both Williams and DiMaggio in order. Here's Willie Mays. That's a 2-9. 2-9 for Mays. He's going to walk. And that'll keep the inning going for Hammer and Hank, who is the tying run at the plate. So Hammer and Hank stepping in against Mejia. It's a 5-8 run to Mejia, but it's good news for Hank Aaron. A 1 to triple. Anything else will be a single with two stars. So it's a 9, so it's a single with two stars. So Mays trots over to third. Runners at the corners with two outs for Mickey Mantle, who homered his last time up. If he does it again, they'll take the lead. It's a 4-10. 4-10 is a strikeout. So Mejia comes back to strike out the Mick. And the Hall of Famers come up empty in the top of the seventh. So we go to the eighth. And both these relief pitchers have a pretty long endurance rating. So they, as long as they're effective, they're pretty much good to go. Here is Ivan Rodriguez. He'll be facing Nolan Ryan. And he may have caught Ryan in his Texas days as well. 2-7. 2-7 is a ground ball to short, and that's an easy play for Ripken for out number one. And we're back to the top of the order in D. Gordon. He's already struck out three times. It's a 6-3 against the lefty. 6-3 is a fly ball to left field X, and the left fielder is Teddy Ballgame, who is a 3, and that's a 1, so that's probably going to drop in for a base hit. Ted Williams, left fielder, a 3, but he found the 1 on the D20, which is never good. And that's actually going to be a double. So it's a double for D. Gordon as he puts one in the gap. And that'll bring up Rafael Palmeiro, another Texas, potential Texas teammate of Ryan. And this is a 3-5. 3-5. 3-5 for Palmeiro is a walk. So 2 on, 1 out for A-Rod, and I'm pretty sure he was after Nolan Ryan. He wasn't around when Ryan was there, I don't believe. He possibly could have been, but I doubt it. It's a 5-10. See here, 5-10 off of Ryan. 1-15 is a double. 16-20 will be a fly to left. It's a 6, so it's a double. So that will score Gordon from second, and they have a chance. They have a chance to score the runner from second. As let's see here how that's going to work. Chance to score him from second base. it's a double 1-15, and it went to center when it's not defined. It's assumed to go to center field. So with that being the case, Willie Mays a -5 arm. They're not gonna risk it with just one out. So they will hold Palmeiro at third, but the not so Hall of Famers tackled another run and lead it 7-4. And we go to Barry Bonds. Runners at the corners and a one out for Bonds. That's a 3-7. 3-7 is another walk. So bases are loaded as Nolan Ryan has gotten the wildest streak going for him. Back to Sammy Sosa. 6-8. 6-8 is a strikeout. So how do you get out of things if you're Nolan Ryan? You get the strikeout going. And that's 3 strikeouts in a row for Sammy Sosa. He's also got the hat trick. Here's Canseco. Bases loaded, 2 outs. It's a 4-5. 4-5 is a strikeout. He has not reached a point of weakness, so he is good to go. Strikeout stands. Inning's over. But the not-so Hall of Famers tack on a run. And we go to the bottom of the eighth with the score. Not-so Hall of Famers 7 and the Hall of Famers 4. And Mejia back out for his second inning of work. He'll be facing Schmidt, Bench, and Ripken. Although he might get a pinch hitter for Ripken. We'll see. Here's Schmidt. It's a 6-12. 6-12 is a ground ball, second base X. And second baseman is D. Gordon, who's a 1. And that's a 13, which is probably an error check. But we shall see. Nope, actually 13 makes it in the range check. It's a ground ball A. So a good play made by D. Gordon. One away, and Johnny Bench steps to the plate. Not going to pinch it for Johnny Bench. Look, I'm trying to roll in this chart, and I still roll it over the end. So let's re-roll again. Call that a foul ball and reboot. We get a 5-6. 5-6 off Mejia is a single. So Mejia gives up a one-out single to Johnny Bench. And they're going to call back Ripken. They're going to go for some more offense. If they, you know, they've got a lot of guys on the bench that can hit, obviously. So they're going to go to their bench, and we'll be right back with the new pinch hitter. Okay, the pinch hitter for Ripken is going to be Roberto Clemente, and then the top of the ninth, Ernie Banks, will be coming into play, shortstop. Right now, Clemente with a chance, with a bench on first, chance to do some damage. Clemente, this is from his 1961 season. He hit .351 with 23 homers, so good card for Clemente. And it's a 2-9, so it's off his own card, but he's going to ground a short into a double play. And that's just the kind of day it's been for the Hall of Famers. They can't buy a break. It's a 6-4-3 double play. Inning is over. So we're going to go to the ninth, and it is still a 7-4 game in favor of the not-so-Hall of Famers. Nolan Ryan still in. Or will he be replaced? Let's see. They may go ahead and make a move here and go to the bullpen. And that's what we're going to do. So we'll be right back with the new Hall of Fame pitcher. Okay, new pitcher is the Goose, Goose Gossage. He's in to pitch the ninth. He'll be facing McGuire, Gonzalez, and Rodriguez. It's a 4-5. 4-5 is going to be a walk. So leadoff walk to McGuire. One away, or one on, nobody out for Juan Gonzalez. And that's a 4-7. 4-7 off of Gossage is a strikeout. So he comes back to strike out Juan Gonzalez. And that brings up Ivan Rodriguez. And that's a 5-11. 5-11 is a ground ball, third base A, and that's going to be a double play. So out of the inning in a hurry is Gossage. And now we go to the bottom of the ninth, and we'll have a new pitcher on for the Not-So Hall of Famers to close it down, Eric Gagne. Be right back with that bottom of the ninth in just a second. All right, Eric Gagne is on to try to wrap things up for the Not-So Hall of Famers. We're at the top of the order, which is Joe Morgan. So Morgan had a rough day. He's 0-3, struck out twice. He did walk and score a run, but he hasn't gotten a hit yet. 4-8. Probably still won't get a hit. 4-8 is going to be a strikeout for Gagne. He was tough. Gagne was very tough in this particular year. This was his card from 2003, and he was 2-3 with a 1.20 ERA, and 55 saves. Struck out 137 in just 82 innings. So loads of strikeouts on his card. One out for Teddy Ballgame. And it's a 6-5. So 6-5 is going to be another strikeout. So Gagne coming in, baffling the Hall of Famers. And it's up to Joe DiMaggio. It's a 1-7, so at least he's off his own card. And as a result, he's going to get a hit. 1-7 is going to be a double or a single. 1-6 will be a double. It's a 4, so DiMaggio laces his third double of the game. He's 3-for-5. All three hits have been doubles. And that brings up Willie Mays. If Mays can get on, Aaron would be the tying run. Mays, at least, is off his own card again, 3-11. 3-11, however, though, he just missed two home run chances and hits a deep fly ball to left, handled by Barry Bonds, and the ball game is over. So the not-so-Hall of Famers, thanks to their juice, they had a distinct advantage against the Hall of Famers and win it by the score of 7-4. We'll be right back with the totals. Okay, we'll wrap up this ball game and the series. The not-so-Hall of Famers win it by the final score of 7-4, which means they win the series 2-1. Let's look at this game 3 total. 7 runs, 11 hits, 2 errors, and 11 left on for the not-so-Hall of Famers. 4 runs, 10 hits, 2 errors, and 9 left on for the Hall of Famers. Winning pitcher was Kevin Brown. He went 6 innings, gave up 7 hits and 4 runs, only 3 earned. Walked 2, struck out 6. Mejia with 2 shutout innings got the hold. And Eric Gagne. I'm thinking of the Minnesota Twins shortstop, Greg Gagne. This is Eric Gagne from the Dodgers. Gave up a double in the ninth to DiMaggio, but racked up 2 strikeouts to earn the save. And Bob Feller, who pitched like old Feller, old Yeller, took the loss. Gave up 3, gave up 5 runs and 5 hits in 3-plus innings to include 4 walks and 2 homers. So Hall of Famers fell behind early 6-1 after 5 innings and just never could recover, particularly 5-1 after 4 innings, and just can never get their their momentum going. They did get the 3 runs in the bottom of the 6th, thanks to, in large part, to a 2-run homer by Mantle, and then an error also helped on along the way. Interestingly enough for the Hall of Famers, if you combine the output of Joe Morgan, Ted Williams, and Willie Mays in this game, they were 0-for-13 with 2 walks and 5 strikeouts. So definitely not something you would expect from them. So hopefully you may not enjoy the outcome. I know I didn't, because I really don't like the not-so-Hall of Famers with their steroids and whatnot. But this is a game of strictly numbers, Stratomatic. So they had those juiced up numbers, so you almost had to kind of expect it, even though they were facing a really staunch Hall of Famer lineup. And Kevin Brown, you would not suspect him to be the powerhouse pitcher that would win the game, but they did. And ironically, the only game the Hall of Famers won was against Roger Clemens, who was arguably the best of the 3 starters that the not-so-Hall of Famers had. They had Clemens, they had Andy Pettit, and Kevin Brown. And the Hall of Famers had Nolan Ryan and Bob Feller in this game. And I believe the second game was Bob Gibson. So, not Nolan Ryan, they had Tom Seaver, Bob Gibson, and now Bob Feller. So, you would think, just on paper, the matchup between those 3 would be a landslide for the Hall of Famers. Didn't work out that way, but that's the way things go here in Stratomatic. That's the way the D20 and the D6s roll. So that's going to do it from here. Hope everybody is having a wonderful time doing whatever board game you choose to play. The important thing is you're having fun doing it and you're rolling those dice. Keep the dice going. And for those in the Stratomatic community, I say strat on. And for everybody else who plays a different game other than Stratomatic, perhaps, I will say that final score, as I leave you again, is Hall of Famers dropping to the not-so-Hall of Famers by the final score of 7-4, and they drop the series 2-1. So until next time, I'll see everybody down the road.